after seeing so many people here, so one word, it is my mother tongue Telugu, it is coming in my thought. Endaro Mahanubhavulu Andariki Vandanamalu. So with this, so I'm going to start my presentation. Sir, is the screen is visible, sir?
Yes, yes.
Yes, sir. You can put it in presentation mode.
Yes, sir. So today's topic is importance of quality parameters in building construction. See, why quality is important? What are the aspects of the quality? If a quality is not implemented in the buildings, what is going to happen? And how effectively the quality parameters has to be put in the implement in the buildings? So this is very, very important. And what IS standards says, what our Indian Institute of Science, or what we call IS standards. So it is says, so everything, so we will able to learn with this presentation. So I need all your cooperation. So first of all, what is quality? So quality is a degree of a state of being free from defects, deficiencies, and substantial variations brought about by the firm and consistent adherence to measurable and tolerable standard to attain uniformity of output that fulfills specific customer requirement. So that means quality is nothing but the customer requirements. It has to fulfill the customer requirement. How it should fulfill? It should free from defects. At the same time, has to have some consistent adherence to measurable. So if you compare with one product with the other product, it has to be in measurable. So that is one thing. And tolerable standards, if slight variations will be there, that slight variation, whether it is in the acceptable standards or not, probably it is in terms of MMs. So that is why the quality is, it should be free from defects and it should adherence to measurable and tolerable standards as per customer requirements. According to International Organization for Standardization, that means ISO, quality is the totality of characteristics of an entity that bear on its ability to satisfy stated needs. As per project management body of knowledge, that is PMBOK philosophy, quality must be planned in and not inspected in. Prevention is more important than inspection. Yes, when we go for the inspection and all, quality has to be in place. So this is what we call it as quality assurance. So whatever we are going to give assurance to the customer, it has to be documented. It has to be in a proper language and a proper record. And the same thing, if you can implement on the ground, it is called quality control. So we will see some of the aspects of how we can able to maintain these quality standards. Quality assurance. Yes, quality assurance is the process of identifying or determining all the quality requirements of a project, classifying prevailing quality documents such as specifications, codes, etc., that are significant to the quality requirements of the project and making them accessible for use. That means the quality assurance, we are giving assurance to the customer that this is what we are going to do in the field. So we are giving right in the beginning itself, this is our SOP, this is our records, and this is our specification. And as per IS codes, this is what we are going to do. So this is the assurance we are going to give in the beginning for the customer. So that is called quality assurance. So the two principles included in quality assurance are fit for purpose. The product should be suitable for the intended purpose, and right first time, mistakes should be eliminated. So whatever the product, whatever the material we are selecting for the project, that material should fit for purpose. So before putting it to use, so we will confirm that the material is the right kind of the material we are going to use in our project. So that is what it is called fit for purpose. To see that whether it is fitting for the purpose or not, there are so many tests. So we will after conducting so many tests and after satisfying with so many parameters, then only we will accept the material. So this is called fit for purpose. And right to first time, yes, the assurance and quality control, what we are going to do. So we have to do with so many SOPs, so many procedures, and so many method statements and all. So we will do the work right from the first time itself. That means it can be avoided, mistakes can be avoided very easily. Quality control. Quality control includes all those jobs or activities performed in the ground or project as per quality procedures or structure prescribed in the quality assurance. So that means whatever we are assured in the quality assurance to the client or customer, the same thing has to be implemented in the ground, so without compromise on the quality. So this is called quality control or quality monitoring. Somebody has to be there while the construction activity is going on. Somebody has to see whether all these things are implementing in the best possible way or not. So this is called quality control. Documents such as project quality plan, quality assurance plan, test plans, job procedures, project specifications, in order to ascertain that the quality targets as laid down in the QA documents are actually achieved in a systematic manner as suggested in these documents. That means this PQP, project specific plan, it is called PSQP, and the project quality assurance plan, all these documents will support to the quality assistance engineer to implement all these quality control documents. The quality documents generated while performing these tasks are called quality control documents or QC documents. Quality policy. Quality policy is a simple. So each and every company or each and every organization, they are having their own policy and stating that policy. They committed themselves to the customer that they are giving the guarantee that we are going to fulfill our quality in the coming project or the ongoing project. So this is what, this is a nothing but a statement. So for example, this is, it goes like this. We all at our construction company are committed at all levels to achieve customer pleasure and dependability through frequent development in the ensuring quality, safety, and timely delivery of our product and services. Actually, this quality policy has to be displayed in the site office or project office. So that much importance has to be given in the quality. So some of the objectives, quality objectives, if we can go through that or introspect ourselves in the quality objectives, we will come across these standards. Implementing quality standards at the site to the maximum extent, yes. And doing works right at the first time itself, that means not doing any rework. The intention should be, so whatever the work we are doing, it will be in the quality standard. As per quality standards, we will bring quality into the construction and we will not go for rework or rejob like that. This is the commitment one should have. Minimizing cost of repairs and reworks, yes. Unavoidable circumstances, the rework may happen because of the some slight modifications of the specifications or afterthought like that. But how far? So there is a limitation for that. Yes, exactly. Below 1%, the minimizing cost and repairs. Otherwise, if it is goes beyond 1% or probably 2% and all, the project is not planned properly and the professionals, they have not thought all professional means. So this is what the conclusion we can come to that. Accepting quality standard materials only. Yes, this is very, very important. See, everybody knows that as a thumb rule in the basic civil engineering, we have 70% component is called material component and 30% component is either labor or workmanship. Imagine if 70% of the component is itself is inferior in quality, so we cannot assurance or we cannot give quality for the material in construction. So that is what we need to accept all standard quality material right from excavation till handing over the key. Carried out all necessary tests in the field, in-house and external. So how to do that quality standard of the materials? Yes, we have so many tests. So I can briefly explain all those things in the coming slides. So finishing products as per customer satisfaction and acceptable limits. Continual improvement of QC engineers through training and development. So this is very important. We need to give training for all engineers who are implementing the quality standards at the site. So somebody may be expert in some items. So, but somebody may be expert in finishing works. Somebody may be in the structural works. But so we want all rounders, not just experts in the one faculty or the other factor. No doubt, we require all those people. But So the training, if you can give training to the QC engineers, the overall implementation of quality can be achieved within a short term. Quarterly implementation of skill matrix of all QCs. Yes, quarterly in the sense, the every 3 months, so we will do some test and interviews and we will mark, so what is the strength, what is the strength, how is he effectively doing his work on the site, and everything we will monitor. And based on this is the skillness, and based on his performance, we can use this skill matrix for all engineers, and we can come to the conclusion that yes, this is the engineer, he is the engineer who can do the wonders at the field. So like that, how we can go for that? So skill matrix. And this is just quality department organization chart, any project, this type of standard project, this thing chart, organization chart will be there, ABCD, for example, VP is the operations head, and the quality head is the reporting to the VP, and he is managing not only for the quality sake and for the safety organization also, he is able to do. So respective engineers, the teams, so many sites he can able to control, and in the safety also, so many people will be assisting here, and he can able to monitor. This is the thing. And the quality control engineer. So what is the role of a quality control engineer? So this is very important. Quality control engineer has to report to the project manager, and he is responsible for many things. So he must ensure the quality records, acceptance limits. So I already told the acceptance limits, it is always in the plus or minus 1 mm, 2 mm, 3 mm, like that. Machineries, equipment calibration, certificates, and the documentation of specific items and buildings areas are prepared and collected in accordance with the project requirements. So coordinate with the planning and quantity surveying department to ensure milestones, dates are understood for each and every activity. See here, the quality, it is a challenging job. The quality control engineer, not only monitoring the quality, not only maintaining the quality aspects, he has to coordinate with the QS department to see that the progress is very, very important for any project. So he has to identify the milestone dates, keeping in mind and not compromising on the quality. It is a balancing the both progress and monitoring the quality. So that role he has to play. Resolve any discrepancies between the completed milestone and quality documentation to provide monthly progress information for completed activities, cost of quality, repairs and rework. Suppose if repairs is happening, why the repairs has happened? So what is the reason and why it has happened? And what is the cost? How much cost is involved? Everything has to be identified and everything has to be documented in these records. Maintain all quality related documents on daily basis. Get it certified from project manager, project management consultants, and clients. All the points mentioned in the checklist, that is before, during, or after the respective activities, to be strictly followed, updated with the signature of the site engineer, project manager, and client representatives on the same day itself. So this is going to be very, very important. If something happens in the construction, so all these documents, so witnessed by many people, project engineer, project manager, quality engineer, and the client, they are all putting the signatures and all. Actually, this is the right method to be implemented in all project sites. Ensure that all inspection reports are accurate and that all the attached documents are current status. Ensure all work is correctly prepared prior to any inspection being undertaken. Assist the site QC manager in the organization maintenance and control of the quality system. So these are the points, important points to be implemented in the quality control. And prepare non-conformance reports to the QA manager and assist in developing corrective actions. So what this means, non-conformance report in the sense, the as the name itself indicates, if the everything is in the conformance, that means there are so many measures for in the IS standards, as per our specifications, as per the bill of quantities and ISO standards. It is not in the civil engineering standards, as per the civil engineering standard, this is called non-conformance. It is not in the conformance with the standards. So what is that non-conformance? We need to identify that, and that report has to be prepared and it has to be submitted to the quality manager. So this is called non-conformance report or NCR. So project quality engineer has got every right to raise the NCR if he not satisfied with any activity. Review work procedures and method statements for compliance with the good practices and the contract or tender documents. So these method statements and work procedures are very, very important. So the work procedures, each and every activity, how the work has to be carried out as per civil engineering norm. For example, if you can take earthwork, it is not an ordinary thing. So it has to be brought in the as per specifications, as per the line and the level, and everything has to be monitored. So the step-by-step of procedures will be there. As per that procedure, the activity has to be taken care. So these are all explained in a systematic way. This is called work procedures and method statements. For example, the chart will help us to identify some of the factors here. I will not go full detail. So just I will mention one or two items here. The inspection and the test plan for all construction works at the project site. This is called quality assurance, QA. So test plan. So we are submitting this test plan in the beginning to the client. So what is this? So serial number, description of activity. For example, description of activity. What is that earthwork excavation, clearance of site, and earth stacking or disposal from project. Imagine this is an activity. So what are the methods? How it has to be done? So type of inspection. What is the inspection? So this is visual inspection. And necessary tools required? Yes. Total station, dumpy level, theodolite. With the help of these, the excavation can be carried out. Reference documents is approved drawings. Testing requirement, acceptance criteria? Yes. With reference to temporary benchmarks, natural ground level, plus or minus 5 mm to 10 mm. This is the tolerance factor accepting here. The inspection. Coming to the inspection point, contractor company is held responsible. Consultant is the reviewer, or PMC is the reviewer. Client is the, again, responsible. If coming back to here, earth disposal or stacking, again, the necessary total station, approved drawing, and contractor held responsible. Reviewer, PMC is the reviewer, and the client is held responsible. Sometimes what happens, PMC is going to be the witness for the particular item important work here. And he has to witness, he has to put his signature here, determine the maximum dry density and optimum moisture content. How to do that? Hot air oven or rapid moisture meter. This is the method of instrument, what we are going to do for the this soil test and all. This is the tool we are using. The approved drawings are IS 2720-1973. As per this, we are going to do this. And conforming standards, conforming specification. Who is responsible? Contractor is held responsible. PMC is the witness. Client is also reviewer. So like this, there are many charts are there. And so with this chart, we can do the complete activities. And coming to the strategy or business plan, these are all the important points we need to go for this. First one is statutory and quality documentation. The project name has to be displayed here. And the project duration. The monthly wise, the project duration has to be displayed here, and the remarks. What are the remarks? What is the comments to be marked here? Statutory and quality documentation, checking plant and machinery plus lab equipment, material received at site, structural work, shuttering, reinforcement, concreting, masonry, plastering, finishing, miscellaneous work, rising NCR, closing NCR, internal auditing, external auditing, site conducts, quality meetings, training program, XQDCM. These are all the points we need to go for. So coming back to this, the statutory and the quality documentation, why it is very important. So statutory documents, as per the government norms, some of the documents are very important, and these documents, without these documents, construction will not happen. So what is that? First one is CAR policy. It is called Contractors All Risk Policy. So this is in force up to, I think, the validity of the contractor all risk policy is 1 year. So here we need to mention that if it is in the force, then it is in force. Suppose if it is in the next month, if it is due, so that date also it has to be mentioned, and it is giving a caution here. The CAR policy, which is next month renewal, it is going to be expired on February 25th. And then we can do that. We can give you indication that February 25th, this is expiring. And before that, please renewal. So that was the point here we are going to mention. So similarly, this is applicable to even WC policy, workmanship compensation policy, labor license, less. How many labor license covered for workers and its validity? What is this validity? So that is also here mentioned, and how many workers it has covered, that is also has to be mentioned here. Project information and emergency contact numbers, this is very, very important. Where is the project is located, what is the address of the project, and emergency contact number. So fire station number, police station number, and ambulance, the medical tying up with the nearest hospital, all these numbers has to be displayed here to see that nothing has to be happened. In case of emergencies, if any untoward incidents are happened, then the with the help of the display numbers, we can contact the available services. And purchase order, LOI, BOQ, all these signed copy with the contractor agreement, that is also important, has to be displayed. Kickoff meeting and approved schedule to be available. Security camera installation for all exits and all exits and entry gates. This is very, very important. What kind of materials it may, whether the truckload is full is having the truckload fully quantity, sometimes M sand or sometimes aggregates or cement bags. So everything we need to monitor with the help of the CCTV cameras. So this is very, very important. So these are all the statutory documents we need to identify. And coming back to the next plant and machinery, crane load test. So you might have seen for the big buildings, a tower crane has to be installed in the center. So that tower crane also, the test has to be done and its validity has to be mentioned here. Builder hoist like that includes ropes, buckets, etc. validity. Concreting batching plant and its validity. See, everything, each point is very, very important. We are not supposed to neglect, not even a single point here. Calibration is again important for compression testing machine, auto level controller, total station, weighing scale 10 kg, weighing scale 100 kg, rapid moisture meter, hot air oven and its validity, RM 800 and its validity. All these things are very necessary important. And this is my favorite chapter. This is called material checking. Each and every material, so for the project, we need to examine, we need to go for the test, and after the testing parameters, satisfy the parameters, then only it can be accepted. Otherwise, if it is not meeting the requirements directly, so quality engineer has every right to reject that material if it is not in the quality standards. For example, RMC, ready mix concreting, M35 grade. Imagine this is M35 grade. What are the test acceptance? Daily appearance. The appearance of the uniformity of the concrete, we need to just in the visual, yeah, that is the one check. And the slump test, 7 days strength, 28 days strength. These are all the some test. And the third party, once in 2 months, this is the test for RMC. And for the coming to the cement, manufacturing test certificate, floor test, approved brand, whether it is in the approved brand or not, that brand name also to be mentioned here. Initial setting time, what is the initial setting time for the cement? What is the final setting time for the same for the cement? And all those things are very, very essential and necessary. And third party, apart from that, these are all the tests we are conducting in our in-house lab or field lab, but randomly third party test also to be conducted for compressive strength, soundness, standard consistency, fineness, and setting time also. Once in a rapidly, we can take some samples and send it for the third party that is called NABL Accreditation Laboratory. There also, we need to check. And if all these three parameters, manufacturing test certificate, our in-house characteristic parameters, and the third party test, NABL Accreditation Lab parameters, if all three things are matched, then we can say that, yes, that particular material is fit for quality. So that is what we said in the beginning. So fit for the purpose. Yes, this particular material is fit for the purpose. This can be used for our project. That is the conclusion we are going to come. And coming back to the steel. Steel is also rolling mass. Steel is very, very important material. So many tests has to be conducted here. Rolling margin. That means if the 10 mm rods, if the less than 10 mm for every 25 meter metric ton, we need to go for the rolling margin. If the 10 mm and the steel bars are between 10 mm and 16 mm, for every 35 meter metric ton, we can go for this rolling margin. And above 16 mm diameter rods, so for 45 metric ton, we can do this rolling margin. And bricks, the dimension, manufacturing test certificate, third party, compressive strength, water absorption. So this is visual check, and for 20 bricks has to be taken for 3 loads of bricks. That means 6 to 7 numbers, each sample has to be taken and subjected to compressive strength. If it is between 35 kg per meter square, 35 kg per centimeter square and above, then only it can be accepted. It is a good quality bricks. Like that, for each source, three numbers to be tested from 20 number of bricks. These are all the some standard. We are not supposed to compromise on these standards. And fine aggregates, C1 LECs, finest modulus, third party test, these are all the tests. Coming to the coarse aggregate, again, same thing. Elongation index is the one of the important aspects. Finest modulus, Flakinex index, third party test, crushing value, impact value. And soil is very, very important. The foundation is entirely depending upon the safe bearing capacity of the soil. So here also, core tech test, core cutter test, in-house and a third party, once for each source of earth at every 100 square meter of compacted earth area. After compaction also, this core cutter has to be done. Moisture content and coming to the structural steel, rolling margin, tensile strength, elongation test, rebend bar test, and tiles, MTC, third party test, plywood also, many tests has to be conducted. Pines, MTC, curb stone, MTC, pavers block, electrical wires, cables, conduits, switch box, GIY, plumbing works, UPVC pipes, sanitary pipes, fixtures, firefighting, MS pipes, welding rocks, sprinkler, HVAC. For all those things, manufacturing test certificate, MTC is required. So these are all the gist of the items. So there are so many materials, so many items are there. I mentioned only the important points here. See, all these important points, it has already crossed more than 20, 25 items. If all these materials, a test has conducted, then only we can say that we are implementing the quality standards and all. So that is pertaining to the material. Here, some activities. These activities are also important. If the shuttering is happening here, what are the quality boards used? What is the brand of the name? And everything has to be disclosed here. Board making, meeting standards, whether it is while doing the board making, whether we have followed the systematic procedure or not. That has to be mentioned here. And enough supports has been given or not. So for the shuttering purpose, side supports, bottom supports, enough supports has been given or not. So how many supports we have given, all those things has to be mentioned here. Alignment, plumb level, and coming to the reinforcement, before reinforcement, whether the shuttering is in order, and during reinforcement, so whether the binding wires has been tied properly or not, whether the lap length has to be in place or not, chairs has been given properly or not, all these things, spacing of stirrups, spacing of roof rods, staircase, everything we need to examine in case of reinforcement. And concreting, again, same. Before, whether the shuttering is proper, reinforcement is proper, electrical conduits are laid properly or not as per the drawings or not, and during concreting, whether the water cement ratio is in the order, whether admixtures has been put, all volumetric batching they are following, or computerized Y-batching system they are following, everything, design mix standards they are following, this is during. And after, so after the thing, whether the sprinkler immediately after the concreting, within 2 hours, whether they are sprinkled with water or not, and whether after the concreting is happened the next day, whether the concrete, cement bands has been temporary, cement bands been erected for storing the water, stacking the water for curing and all these things coming into the concreting. Brickwork, plastering, finishing works, before, during, after, checklist. This is very, very important. And coming to the miscellaneous aspects also, road, drawings, STP, ETP, before, during, after, checklist. And rising NCR, if non-conformancy is happening, how many NCRs we have issued, how many NCRs we have raised, and whether this issues has closed or not. If it has to be closed, it has to be done in a proper way. What is the root cause? Why it has happened? What are the prevention actions we have taken? And what is the reason why it has happened? All those things in the document evidence, it has to be proved, and then only the issues will be closed. And internal audit. So internal auditing is the team. The site inspection has to be carried out in each and every stages at a different stages of the activity or project. So in that case, how many times the internal audit has been done? Monthly once or 3 months once, or everything has to be noted here. Issues open, how many points they have raised, and how many points out of that, how many points your project site engineer or project engineer has closed that issues, everything has to be recorded here. if you are very much familiar with the internal auditor, and if you are giving importance to the internal points, auditing points, then external audit is very easy to tackle. The external audit is nothing but the person who is third party, who is not favor of either in favor of what we call client or in not in the favor of customer or engineer, is entirely independent agency, third party audit or external audit. So these people will come and they will also raise some objection, and that has to be followed. The same thing, whatever I have told in the internal audit, the same thing is applicable here. The site meetings, how many meetings we have conducted in the site, monthly, regularly, weekly, so everything. Quality meeting attended at the office, or how many officers meeting has conducted in giving importance to the quality. Training program at the HO, all these things. So then only we can say, if we can fulfill these, yes, we can do the quality checks. And these are all the theory part. And interesting part here is quality control. How effectively we can do the quality control during roof concreting. See here, so myself is standing here. So whoever may be the representative, they have to stand there and they can examine each and every activity here. You can see here, the concreting is happening here. The water cement ratio is very good. Water cement here, ratio we have maintained here. The compaction of the concrete and vibration, everything is happening here. You can see in the photograph itself, the thickness of the slab here, the same thickness is here is also. That means uniform level, uniform consistency we are maintaining here. Coming to the reinforcement here, the reinforcement, the top bars, bottom bars, how effectively it has been carried out here with the help of the cover block and the electrical works, the conduits, everything is in intact, and binding ways with the proper binding ways, these side supports and everything has been tied properly. So this is one such kind we need to follow while doing concreting. And if the plinth beam is happening here, you see the quality standards, how effectively they are maintaining here, the giving supports. Here in the photograph itself, you can make out no bulging, nothing is there. The straight lines, how the alignment effectively they are maintained with the help of the supports and with the help of the monitoring, even for the bolts, central foundation bolts, how effectively the center of gravity has been transferred effectively in the field. So this is what it is, very, even for the minute details also, it has to be carried out effectively. That is why quality parameters, quality is very, very important. And here you can see in the Bishop Cotton Boys High School, so we have done these columns, circular columns, which is 30 feet height here. So one such column, so how much quality we have given importance. See here, the finishing also, this is an unfinished work, just one coat primer has been done here. So no undulations, nothing is there. So this is, if we can do such a type of quality, so we can enjoy the quality and we can see that, yes, on the same night, if you go for the sleep, so you will have a satisfaction that, yes, so today I have done some quality work. So that is the kind of the work we need to do. And reinforcement work, even in the photographs also, you see the enjoyment and the beauty of the reinforcement here, the top bars, bottom bars, the sunken portion, how effective the alignment itself. If these are all the pre-requirement things, this is, I already explained before concreting. See, this is what before concreting, if these are all in the lines, even after concreting also, you can maintain the same line here. So this is what we need to introspect ourselves. Here also in the sunken beam, how closely the stirrups has been monitored and how closely the effectively top bar, bottom bars has stayed in position and all. So this is very, very important. We have to give even for the minute details that much importance. And here before concreting, see how effectively the plumb has to be transferred in the ground. So this is one example for the Kongavi Electronics project, what we have done. And before casting columns, all standard like reinforcement, foam for shutters using plyboards as a shuttering oil, etc. were followed at all our projects. See here how effectively the gloves has to be in place, the stirrups and everything has monitored, and starters, the foam for the starters, plywood with the waterproofing oil, I mean shuttering oil and everything in place. So this is some of the photographs. I'm saying these are all the points we need to do for the while visiting the buildings. And here, all appropriate safety measures were taken while casting RCC gutter at 20 meters height. See, imagine, this is just four bays I'm showing here. Only for the four bays, this much scaffolding material is involved. This is gutter we are casting at 20 meters height, imagine. The next photograph, you will be able to see that. Here, not only for the quality parameters, the safety is paramount important for each and every person here. Imagine the how much safety nets has been tied here, the safety principles, PPEs, safety nets, and safety belts, everything is intact. Suppose if something is happened, the person is falling from here. So he will fall from here only, the 1 meter, in the, within 1 meter depth only, he will fall. Such a kind of safety nets has been arranged. So safety is important. Human lives are more important, even rather for quality, compared to quality, safety is paramount important. We are giving utmost importance to the safety also here. And see, the same gutter, RC gutter at 24 meter height, length 110 meter under progress, fulfill all standard. Imagine this is 110 meter length. That means nearly 350 feet length of the gutter, which is 1.2 meter depth and 1.1 meter width and 30 centimeters. The two gutters are carrying out here. The concreting is happening here. That means 110 meter length, the line, alignment, plumb, everything, quality standards we are maintaining. And here, the verticality of column of the same project, the verticality of the column up to 24 meters height. From here to here, it is 24 meter height. The beams at 5 meter interval, 13 meter interval, and 20 meter, and RC gutter at 25 meter, starting at 25 meter level, with 1 meter width and 1.2 meter depth. This is 1 meter width and 1.2 meter depth. All are maintaining quality standards in all respects. You can imagine in the photograph itself, you can make that alignment, length, plumb, everything. So this is what, so I'm expecting the quality like this. Even if you can give minute details, importance to the minute detail, so this is the result you can expect after quality. And this is one example I can give. Skyway under construction at Wonderla, Hyderabad, more than 12 floors and a height of 46.2 meters stands example for uniqueness of our quality standards. So this is recently it has been done. That means 3 years back, 46.2 meters. It is nothing but 150 feet. Wonderla Skyway at Hyderabad. This has been giant wheel which is coming here. So a lot of scaffolding materials and a lot of challenging project. So much importance has been given here. You can see the next photograph. You can see the close-up view. You will come to know that. So this is the under construction. The Skyway is happening here. So this is the finishing work, the glazing and everything started here, Wonderla for Hyderabad project. And standard way of giving supports to the shuttering, UG tank, underground sump tank. So this is the kind of so much supports is required in order to carry out effectively the retaining walls. See here in the shuttering itself, you can make out that how much importance we have given. If it is a 20 centimeters, yes, exactly. From here, it is 20 centimeter. Here also, it is to be 20 centimeter. That means all the materials has to be intact in a tight waterproof platform. Then only you can expect the very good quality. These are all the things necessary in the construction. And next. Quality auditing during the construction of projects. What is the necessity of the auditing? And so the red letters indicates that whenever I go to the site, whenever I find some faults or some improvements, I always point it out in the red letters. See here, for example, earth backfilling is okay for this particular item, but proper compaction with the core cutting to be done before 22/7/2016. That was the deadline I have given and should achieve more than 95% proctor density. So this was the point I pointed out in the auditing. How effectively the site people have taken very seriously, and the same day itself they started compacting and core cutting results and everything they have started, they're done. And after that, the core cutting done on 16/7/2016. I have given the deadline for 22/7. So well in advance, they have done in on 16th itself. So at 6.25 p.m., and the proctor density achieved is 98.32%. So this is the evidence and this is the documental proof. So this is what quality documents I already told. So that is very, very important. And here, so this is not acceptable, such a kind of things, 10 pipes are coming at one place, chasing like this. And this is not a standard method. Given the instruction here, they followed the same instruction after fulfilling the instruction. So this is the thing effective way. So this is what we are expecting. And in the NETAP project, what has happened, West Ice compound wall near main building, wall bulging to be rectified. See here, the how much bulging from the naked eye itself you can make out here, this is not acceptable. So in this case, NCR has been issued. See here, after everything, I have given the solution also rectified with the grinding machine. So they have done effectively, they have completed all these things in the same photograph, compound wall bulging rectified by grinding. So even if mistakes will happen, and so I'm not saying that we are Brahmas or we are Indras to can construct without any mistake, but mistakes will happen. But rectification and doing at the right time and the rectification at the proper appropriate time within the setting time itself, then that is called intelligence. If we can do that, yes, we can, Aramse, we can say that we are also implementing quality standards in our projects. And here also in Tata Power, see, you can see that here the gap is more. That gap not to be filled with the mortar or something like that. I have suggested the concrete. After concreting, they have done here. So that was the result. And you can ask here, so quality audit for completion stage projects. So what I have shown up to this time is undergoing projects. And here, after completion projects, this is now also, so in the pandemic situation, on October 4th, 2020, this is an example for Mr. Chandrasekhar residence construction at BDA Lout, Banchankri, sixth stage. See, while seeing from the outer look, this project is very good, sounds to be okay. But when he entered inside, there are so many points for observation. See here, for example, the support for the wash basin they have given, so which is not sufficient. So just on the just granites, a 20 mm thick slab, they have placed this wash basin. So while just touching itself, it is shaking. So in order to not compromise with the quality and for the aesthetic point, what I have suggested is this L clamp I have suggested with stainless steel, 450 mm for the wash basin side and 300 mm for the wall side. If you can do like that, this can be minimized. And inside staircase, these are all the dampness points. So examined here and the necessary measures. So I have given the instruction. Even for the pipes also, see here, the pipes verticality is very, very important. Otherwise, if the water pressure is more, the bulging will happen and this is not going to be long lasting. So these are all the important points we need to examine. And coming to this one more important project recently, just last month only, so I have done the auditing for this particular project. So this is four floor building. So having, I think probably A block and B block consists of more than 180 flats. See in the Singhasandra, Bangalore. So while seeing elevation, so quality has maintained, we can come to that conclusion. But inside, there are so many points. See here, all external walls, so many cracks are there, external walls. These cracks has to be minimized and this has to be attended regular fashion. So this is my observation point. And here also second coat painting, they have not done. The people are occupied and they have not taken, the builder has not given importance to the quality here. And here, the worst affected factor is here, the quality here, absolutely bad. The waterproofing work they have conducted here, they have done here, all patchy works here, dark circle below water tank. So much water is seepaging here. As a result, there is a dark circle here, black patches are there. Even below the flat, people are hesitating and they are not willing to stay there in the houses because of so much dampness and all. They requested while doing the auditing, they came. Literally, they met me and they said, sir, please come and do some justice for here. The next photograph, see here, the people, they requested me to attend their flats and inspect their flat, what best how can do. So that is the thing that they are expecting here. So while doing the auditing, these are all the points important. While taking the project, each and every point is very, very important. If you're not doing the justice, we have to take the cursings or blame from the people. So this should not happen. So after all these things, so this is, I think this is going to be the last, my end of the presentation. These are all the suggestions for the same projects I have given. Permanent solution for terrace floor issues, how it has to be done effectively. So making black dampness marks removed by scraping with a hardwood brush and the joints to be widened by making a V-gross, a 3mm depth, all these. So if they can do that, but this is nothing but a postmortem, but it can be, I think some guarantee can be given, not full guarantee. So what I mean to trying is, if we can do the project in the initial stage itself, we can minimize all these problems. So this is what I hope that this presentation is useful and people can understand the importance of quality and all. So my sincere request is please take professional help for the all projects and don't go for just ordinary masonries or unprofessional people to don't experiment your construction because it is a hard earning money. In as per the saying, in lifetime we can construct either one building or probably two buildings. So we don't want to take any risk on the chances. So thank you very much for the patience listening. Thank you very much.